Dave, everybody. He's a very funny guy. Love Dave. How's everybody doing tonight? Fuck, everybody's gonna ask you that. I love being in Guelph, one of my favorite cities, to be quite honest with you. I love doing comedy, and I love doing comedy when it's for a good cause. So, again, thank you very much for coming. It's a pleasure to be here. Love coming out here. I just think I said that. I usually do shows in Guelph, I usually do them downtown. There's a fair amount of clubs downtown. I think I might open, it's a little different than this side of Guelph, I feel. I might open a restaurant downtown Guelph. And it will just be like my mom from a little limo on a plane, $15. Yeah. Organic, vegan, vegetarian.
Bringing up the
scene. No buy that. I almost went to University of Guelph, actually. There's really only two things to say. Does anybody go to University of Guelph? Of course you don't. Picked one school within a 50-kilometer radius. Nope. Right. I almost went there. Only two things really stopped me: applying and my marks. Even if I did apply, is it awkward for you to sit there? I feel like it's hard for you to look at me because you're not sure if you should look right at me, like you're right here. Like Pervert Row at a comedy club is way different than Pervert Row at a strip joint. So got nice ass. It is nice of you, though. I've been doing a lot of shows in Brantford, Ontario.
Does that happen in
America? Yeah, right. I know. I'm very popular in Brantford. I don't know why. I really fucking know. But man, that's a tough town. I don't know if you've been in Brantford lately, but Christ, that's a tough town. I walked into a bar that I was doing a show, and these two guys were kicking the shit out of this guy. Like, just stopping him, punching him. I looked at the bartender, I'm like, are you going to call the cops? He's like, why would I? Look what happened to the first guy. Fair enough. I'm going to drink during the set, sorry. I've been drinking all day. I hate it when it hits 15 degrees on a Saturday. Well, I mean, my family and my girlfriend and shit hate it when it's 15 degrees on a Saturday, because then I just don't care about anything except like really and watching baseball. And I hate baseball. It's really just an excuse to keep drinking. I was talking about Brantford and how tough they are, but you know what's funny? When I think about Guelph, I grew up in Kitchener. I grew up on like the east, I don't know, the far end of Kitchener, which is closest to Guelph. And in between Guelph and Kitchener, it's just farmland. Farmers everywhere. So a lot of farm kids went to my high school, went to Grand River in Kitchener. And those guys, there's nobody tougher than farm kids. They're the toughest you get because they don't even know they're tough. But when you're waking up at 5 a.m. since you were 6 years old to bale fucking hay, you just automatically are tough. So I had a good friend that lived out in Arthur, little shit town. I went into Arthur and went down like his driveway, which is longest street I live on, and I get to the barn. And I open the barn, and he's got the pickup truck in one hand, doing an oil change. In the other hand, he's pulling a fucking calf out of a mother cow. I'm like, hey, Mike, you need a hand? No, why? All right. Yeah, my mistake. He's a big hunter, too. He likes to shoot shit. Eat it. Am I allowed to swear about that? Yeah, he likes to shoot slaves. Is there any hunters here?
No.
Yeah? You never be cussing in your own But I appreciate it. Thank you. He's a big hunter, so, but he was one of these guys. When he killed something, he ate it all. Like, I mean, the whole goddamn thing, he did everything. And one time I was like, hey, Mike, what are you eating? He's like, I don't know, something I killed last year. Like, what are you eating? And I'm like, oh, I don't know, a Kit Kat junkie. And he just walks out and he's like, what are you, gay? Like, what? I don't know. It's not like I was eating it like, ah. I mean, it was chocolate all over my face, but it wasn't quite like that. Funny thing is, 3 years later, it turned out he was actually asking, hope I'd say yes. And that was tough. That was tough for old Mike, because his dad was as religious as you get. And a lot of religious people aren't into, you know, the whole, you know, that's two penises, by the way. Not into that. So I went over to their house once, actually. I'm a pretty liberal guy. I don't really care what you do. It doesn't affect me. Why do I care? So I'm a pretty liberal guy. And he says to me, he's like, Sammy, are you really for gay marriage? I'm like, well, I don't really know your son that well, but we'll see if he bites me. Beer and blows me.
No worries,
and the chance. He didn't find that funny either. But of course I'm for gay marriage. Gay people should have the exact same right to straight people. I mean, of course, right? Until there's a cure, at least. I'm kidding. I actually am totally 100% gay. I have a lot of friends that are gay. I'm a comedian, for Christ's sake. Half of them are gay. As a matter of fact, I'm totally for gay marriage, of course. As a matter of fact, I think it would be a lot easier to date a guy. That'd be great. Hey, remember when you called my dad an asshole like 3 years ago? No. Yeah, me either. Want to watch hockey and drink each other off? Yeah, I totally do. That would be a lot. But I think that's where I kind of draw the line sometimes. Just not my thing. I don't care what people do. I mean, there was just one time in college, but that was the drugs. Anyway. I don't really care what some people do. I don't know what people do. I really don't care who you're with, whatever. As a matter of fact, like if it wasn't for the sex thing, it probably would be great. Because there have been times where I'm arguing with my girlfriend, and the whole time I'm thinking, I gladly suck every dick in the city. If you could shut the hell up for 2 seconds, that would be amazing. Yeah. Yeah, my girlfriend hates that joke too. Did you put a roofie in here? You don't need to. Just say no. I'm easy. What was I talking about? Oh, relationships. Yeah. So relationships are complicated. Like, how many people are actually in a relationship right now? Like, a serious relationship? None of you. All right. It's a swingers night. All right. I'm taking my shirt off. That's it. They're tough. Relationships are tough. I got a text from an ex-girlfriend last week, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, hadn't talked to her in years. Like, it was 1 o'clock in the morning. But 1 o'clock in the afternoon, haven't talked to her in years, we dated for years. This is what she sends me. I'm going to read this to you. Now, this is the BlackBerry, so talk amongst yourselves for 10 minutes. We may as well have 2 games on the street. All right, so this is it. Haven't talked to her in years. Haven't seen her in years. This is what she texts me, verbatim, word for word. Hey. I know. I saw the look of your face. Like, what? I know. So I text back the only thing we can to that is, hey. I'm thinking, you know, this is what I'm saying. But that's what it is. And men are simple. I'm not saying it's good or bad either way, it's just how it is. But men need simple things in their life. They need food, they need beverages, they need sex, they need work, they need money. Women need the exact same things. They need sex, they need money, they need to work. Okay? But women also have other things in their right head. Men just don't give 2 shits about. Like home decor. You ever been in a Bed Bath & Beyond and your girlfriend hands a pillow to you? What do you think about this whole pillow? It works. So when she texted me, it got me to thinking of an argument that we had then, which I didn't know was an argument until she got really mad at me. She's like, hey, it was simple. Hey, babe, where do you want to go eating? Doesn't matter, I don't care. Then I could just feel it. Like, what? She's like, it doesn't matter, you don't care where we go to eat. I'm like, no, just pick a place to eat. I don't care. She's like, well, I'm not picking a place, you pick a place. I'm like, I'm absolutely not picking a place. She's like, why aren't you picking a place? I said, there's a chance of me picking a place that you don't like, or sexually higher than you picking a place that I don't like. As a matter of fact, you can pick any restaurant within a 1,000-kilometer radius of this place, and I would find something to eat. I guarantee I can eat it. She's like, well, that's not true. Because I've taken you to the best old restaurant in this city like 3 times, and every time you order the skin salad with the candy trick and roll, that's what they eat half of my steak. Well, I know, but I see all of the steak. I mean, hell, no, I get that, but you know who did? I did. I just find the next question. The next question is, what should I wear? Again, don't know, doesn't matter, don't care. It's like, oh, you don't care. You don't care what I wear. You don't care what I look good. That wasn't even the question, actually. I assumed you're going to try and look good. It's like, well, if you don't care what you wear, I'm going to wear my Halloween outfit from last Halloween. And dressed up as Wonder Woman last Halloween, so I really hope you do, actually. You probably won't make it to dinner. That's not a threat. A threat would have been if she told me she was going to dress up like she did when she was in grade 5. That's what would have been a little weird, having sex with SpongeBob later that night. But a lot easier to clean up. Yes, I got it. He's a sponge. He's a big sponge. And anyway, so she's finally like, well, what are you going to wear? Well, I was pretty much dressed like this. I said, well, I want it to be a surprise pretty big, but ta-da! What do you mean what I'm going to wear? This is what I'm going to wear. So, fine. I'm like, I'm about to eat my freaking arm. So I'm like, you know what? Just put on the Wonder Woman outfit and let's get a freaking steak. And we can talk about it. Or two. Is there anybody married? Well, you have a dry ring on your hand, so I'm going to guess that you are, or you're hoping to be. You don't have to hide it. Is that your wife? No? Oh. Yeah! Why, is it your sister? Oh. Well, who is it? Wait, I don't know. How absolutely. I've never been married. I don't know if marriage is my thing. I think one of my things with being married, I'm just too immature. Right, like people say to me, are you married? I'm like, no, I'm way too young. I'm like, no, I'm not. I'm like 40 years old. I just don't get it. I think I'm going to, like, immature me just once bringing. So I feel bad for the woman that was actually married to me. Like the other day, I have a 200-pound St. Bernard. And he decided to take a huge diarrhea on the front lawn. You know? So I grabbed the plastic bag and I go to pick it up. And as I picked it up, I could feel something on my hand coming down. And I ran around the front lawn of my house in one of the busy streets in Kitchener just like, there's a hole in the bag! There's a hole in the bag! There's a hole in the bag! With dog shit running down my hand. That's not what addicts do. No. They don't scream like little girls, but I can't help it. I think what is going to happen when I decide to get married, because I'm not against marriage, if I find somebody that I could stand me for more than an hour, yeah, sure. But I think what I'll do, I think I'm going to have a serious conversation with my penis before I get married. He should really know what's going on, to be honest with you. Just like, hey, buddy, this is me talking to my penis, by the way. Hey, buddy, yeah? I don't know what he sounds like, but you know Kelly? Yeah, I know Kelly. Yeah, we've been dating Kelly for a while now. Yeah, I know. I've been rope waiting this one out. I've been tickling for a team. Well, that's the thing. We're going to marry Kelly. What? Yeah, so you know what that means, right? What? That means that you can't go inside any other women. Not in their hand, not in their mouth, not in their body, nowhere. Done. Unless Kelly says it's okay. You're kidding me. No, that's true. Okay. Well, here's the good news, big guy. You're married. You can have sex with her anytime you want. Really? No, not really. See you on your birthday. Thank you very much, everybody. My name is Henry Fry. I really appreciate it. I'm totally going to win those tickets, by the way. I'm going to burn them.
All right, give another big hand for Sandy Frohn, everybody. Give him another big round of applause. Yes. Nice and done.
Thank you guys for coming. Thank you guys for showing.